It's finally election day, and Donald Trump is still the Republican nominee, but without the support of some of the members of his party. And that includes Maryland's governor, Larry Hogan.
And I think Governor Hogan is to be commended for having the guts and the courage to say, I am not voting for that man.
While Governor Hogan's not said who he'll vote for, he's made it clear it won't be Donald Trump.
It's hard for me to know what Governor Hogan's true motivations were, but my read of the situation is that we had a combination of his values fitting together with what's best for him politically.
And according to recent polls, Marylanders overwhelmingly like the job Hogan's been doing.
First of all, I want to say that it's pretty remarkable that Governor Hogan has been soaring in his favorability ratings when you consider that he is the first Republican governor in many years since Bob Ehrlich before. And it's such a blue, blue, blue state.
And that's a fact not lost on Bruce Poole, chairman of the Maryland Democratic Party.
I think if I were advising the governor, I would like very much that his poll ratings are high. That's a really good thing to be liked by people. But you can be liked and not necessarily followed.
And Delegate Will Smith thinks it will take more than just popularity for Hogan to win re-election.
Again, going back to this really this polls over principles approach, which is tremendously popular, but it doesn't really provide a grand vision to really propel our state forward. And that's what you need. And so for the Democratic nominees coming up, I'm looking for really robust and grand ideas.
Democrats still hold a 2-to-1 edge over registered Republicans in Maryland. But says Poole,
if we go over 2-to-1, if we have 2.5-to-1 or even, my gosh, a 3-to-1 ratio, that's huge for Democrats because it shows that if you have the right message, if you have the right candidate and campaign, I'm talking about here in Maryland, then things can change dramatically and very, very quickly.
As for the governor, some suggest he may have to do a little work to bring back some of his party members.
If Governor Hogan is looking to win over Republicans in the next governor's race, it's going to be important for him to bring those Trump supporters into the fold for him.
And the clock is running. The gubernatorial primary is set for June 26, 2018. In Annapolis, Shelby Copeland, CNS-TV.